In this video, we are going to delve into the Intermediate Value Theorem, often referred to as the IVT. Through this video, we'll explore what the IVT exactly is and how it is applied. Imagine there's an escalator here, which applies from the first floor to the fourth floor. Since this escalator continues without any breaks or jumps, the person similarly goes up from the first floor to the first floor without any issue. Now, let's consider whether this person will necessarily pass the second floor height. Yes, because this escalator moves continuously from the first floor to the fourth floor, the person will definitely pass the height of the second floor. Now, look at a slightly different scenario. Here you can see oddly shaped escalator that moves up and down like a roller coaster. In this case, the person will cross the height of the second floor more than once. If you consider the left starting position of the escalator as A, F of A and the ending position as B, F of B, then the escalator is horizontally connected from x equals a to x equals b. Its starting height is f of a and its ending height is f of b. In this scenario, if c is located between a and b, then the passenger on this escalator must necessarily pass through the height f of c at least once. This is precisely the essence of the intermediate value theorem. Now, let's summarize and write down the mathematical definition of IVT. If f is continuous on the closed interval, x is in between a and b inclusive, f of a is not equal to f of b, and k is any number between f of a and f of b, then there's at least one number c in the interval, x is greater than or equals a or less than or equals b, such that f of c is k. The crucial conditions here are that the function f of x must be continuous on the interval between a and b, and the heights at the beginning and the end must be different. In other words, the escalator must move continuously and not have the same height at both ends. Additionally, the value k represents the height of some floor between f of a and f of b. Earlier, I mentioned that this theorem can be used to verify the existence of solutions for functions. Let's work through an example. Suppose we have f of x equals x cubed plus 2x minus 1, and we want to use the IVT to prove that there exists a 0 between 0 and 1, assuming that f of x is continuous on this interval. When you plug in 0 into f of x, we get f of 0 is 0 plus 2 times 0 minus 1 equals negative 1, and when you plug in 1, we get f of 1 is 1 plus 2 minus 1 equals 2. In other words, this escalator is traveling from the basement floor, minus 1, to the second floor, continuously without any interruptions, within the interval between 0 and 1. Therefore, it is evident that while traveling from the basement to the second floor, at least once, the escalator must cross the ground floor, which is 0 level. Consequently, we can confidently state that within the interval 0 and 1, there must be at least one value of x for which f of x equals 0. The second example is a multiple choice question. Given that x ranges from values between 1 and 10, and we have f of 2 is negative 5, f of 5 is 5, and f of 9 is negative 5, we can plot these points on the graph, creating a curve that passes through them. Since the problem states that f of x is differentiable, it means that f of x is continuous within the given interval of x and is also differentiable. For those who are curious about continuity and differentiability, there are related videos available in the top right corner link. Feel free to check them out for more information. Now, let's consider the answer choices. First, f has an at least two zeros. Looking at the graph, it is evident that the curve crosses the x-axis at least twice. This means it has at least two zeros. Additionally, if we were to draw a more intricate curve passing through these points, it could have even more zeros. Therefore, the first statement is true. Second, f of x has at least one horizontal tangent. Since the function is differentiable, the graph passing through these three points must turn smoothly without sharp turns, resulting in the possibility of having horizontal tangents. If the graph passing through these three points were more complex, like the one shown on the screen, you will have more horizontal tangents. Therefore, the second statement is indeed true. Third, for some c, between 2 and 5, f of c is 3. This condition questions whether there is just a value of c between 2 and 5, where the graph passes through the height of 3. As shown in the graph, f of x passes through the height of 3 at least once between 2 and 5. Hence, this statement is also true. Consequently, all three statements are true, leading to the answer E. Today, we will explore what the intermediate value theorem is and how it can be applied. In our next session, we'll delve into mean value theorem and Wohl's theorem. If you have any questions or thoughts about the video, feel free to leave them in the comments. Your valuable feedback will be greatly appreciated. How did you find today's video? If you enjoyed it, please consider subscribing and liking. Thank you for watching. I will see you next time. I've been your math guardian, Alex.